Good morning, everyone. A warm welcome to the virtual open house 2024 of St. Gabriel's Primary School. I'm Mrs. Serene Cordero, and I will be your host for today. Please take note of some admin instructions before we begin. If you have any questions, feel free to type them into the Q&A box, and we will address them during the Q&A section. Do note that today's webinar will also be recorded and uploaded to our school's website. Through our webinar, gain insights into how our Gabrielites are developed holistically as leaders, sportsmen, and achievers as they walk in the footsteps of our founder, St. Louis-Marie de Montfort. Let's watch a video of our Gabrielites in action.
If I'm elected as your head prefect, I'll try my utmost best to serve all Gabrielites.
Thank you.
Let me now introduce our school leaders and the presenters for the webinar. We have with us our principal, Mr. Martin Tan, and our vice principals, Mr. John Lim and Madam Ivy Chua. We have Mr. Jimmy Tong, Head of Department for Physical and Health Education and CCA. He will share on the signature program, Gabolite Football Academy, GFA, as well as the wide variety of CCAs, which help our students to excel as sportsmen. For our Q&A segment later, we also have Head of Department of CCE, Student Development and School Community Partnerships, Mrs. Jessica Hui; Head of Department of Discipline, Safety and Partnerships, Ms. Lau Mei Ling; Head of Department of English Language, Mrs. Michelle Tan; Head of Department of Mother Tongue Languages, Ms. Wan Chui Ting; Subject Head of Mother Tongue Languages, Ms. Palani; our year head for lower primary and middle primary respectively, Mrs. Doreen Lee and Madam Christine Lee; and our admin managers, Ms. Chua Bi Peng and Ms. Lindia Lin. Without further ado, I shall invite our principal, Mr. Martin Tan, to shed some light on the milestones of SGPS, as well as the Gabolite experience. Mr. Tan, please.
Thank you, Sareed. Good morning, parents. Welcome to the St. Gabriel's Primary School e-open house. It's really good to see all of you here this morning, and thank you very much for joining us. First of all, I must apologize that we delayed the start by about 5 minutes to allow more parents to be able to join us. So it's really good to see so many of you this morning. And really, I'd like to begin by saying that the objective of this open house is to allow parents to make an informed decision, because you have got a very important decision to make coming up soon with your child joining primary one. Of course, some of you may be quite familiar with the primary school scene because you have other children already in the school system. So I hope that today you will find the session helpful, useful for you to make this decision. At the same time, I'd like to share that we have gone for the e-open house mode so that parents from all over can join us from the comfort of your house at your own convenience. Or because this is already the school holiday, some of you may already be traveling. I won't be surprised if some of you are joining me from Sentosa or Malacca or Bangkok, right? Since today is the first day of the school holiday, something I'm sure the children looking forward to. So I also like to assure parents that after today's session, right, after today's e-open house, which we will share a lot with you, if you find that you need to make a physical visit to the school after today, just drop us an email. Okay, we'll be happy to arrange for a group tour for parents who are interested to visit us physically, to have a look at the facilities. And you know, boys, sometimes they like to actually come and walk around, look at the school field, look at the playground, look at the canteen, to give them a warm feeling, you know, to give them an inviting feeling about the school before you make the decision. So no worries, right? Just let us know after today if you would like to actually visit the school. Just drop us an email. So before I go on further, I just like to share a little bit about myself. I've been a principal for 18 years. This is my third school. I was principal of Anderson Primary, a co-ed primary school. Then I was at Northlight School for 7 years, a specialized school for children who are struggling in their education due to various reasons like lack of family support or special learning needs. And it was a very meaningful attachment to the school, right? And then after that, I've now been in St. Gabriel's Primary School for 6 years and enjoying every moment here with all our wonderful boys, right? And I'm married. I have a son who is now, surprisingly, you may not believe me, but my son is 25 years old. Pleased to share that he just finished his uni exams and will be starting work next month, much to my great relief, right? Suddenly, my shoulders feel so much lighter, right? And of course, I'm a Catholic myself in a Catholic school, so I'm very at home here, right? And I look forward to you and your sons joining us in the St. Gabriel's Primary School, the Gabrielite family, right? Now, so the question on your mind, why St. Gabriel's Primary School? Why SGPS? I think the answer is very simple. Right, and every year we poll the parents who join us in primary one. Every year we survey, and it's very clear that parents choose St. Gabriel's Primary School for a few reasons. Topmost reason is they are looking forward to all-round holistic education for their boys. They are looking for a balanced education, a school which looks into their all-round development in the physical, aesthetic, social, emotional, cognitive, all right? And not a school that only emphasizes academic achievement. Of course, I must say upfront that St. Gabriel Primary School develops our students in all areas, all right? And definitely, even as the education system is now gradually shifting its focus to reduce the emphasis on exams, we place great emphasis on enabling our children to do well in their studies as well, right? Which is what a good all-round holistic education is all about, right? And you will find that the boys here learn a lot about the virtues, all right? Like respect, self-discipline, perseverance, and they get a lot of opportunities to apply in their daily lives. They learn about teamwork, right? They learn about learning to live and work with their schoolmates, right? They learn 21st century competencies like collaboration, which I think all of you parents will agree with me. Today, in the society, in the workplace, this is what our students need, right? A lot of EQ, AQ, some of you may even call it, right? To go with the IQ. Now, the other reason why a lot of parents actually choose St. Gabriel's Primary School, as we know, is because we are known for our very strong culture of care. Our very strong culture of care in the school, right? Where it starts with the school leaders, like myself, caring for my staff. And then in that way, the staff actually show the great care to our boys as well. Right, so we look after the boys, right, as if they are our own. And it is one of the philosophy of the staff, treat each child as our own. And I'm very glad to say that over the past few years, all right, I've seen it with my own eyes, all right, the staff actually doing that, treating each child as their own, looking after them from sunrise to sunset, right? And it is not uncommon. Right, even if you drop your children in school, you will see the school leaders out there in the front foyer welcoming the boys, seeing to the boys' safety, right, and helping the boys in many ways when they are with us. And if you have neighbors or relatives whose children are with us, and if you know some of our boys, you can speak to them firsthand. They are always very happy coming to school. They look forward to school. Just like yesterday, we ended the term on a high. We had a book character day where we have many boys who came dressed as Harry Potter, Willy Wonka, Super Mario, right? And it was an effort to encourage boys to read, you know, to read widely, all right? And the boys had a blast yesterday. And this was coupled with long recess for the boys, from the usual half an hour recess. Yesterday, the boys had 1 hour recess. They had the time of their life yesterday in school, right? So we create moments like this where our boys have great memories about school. They feel inspired to come to school and want to learn, right? And I think that's very important for primary education, right? That we really motivate the children, right? Help them develop a very positive growth mindset about what school is, what learning is, what making friends is all about, right? So that they will have the spirit of lifelong learning, right? And of course, like the theme of today's open house, right? For those who have been with us, I think some parents here may have children with us. Leader, sportsman, achiever. These three student outcomes are well known to every parent, every Gabrielite, every staff, right? So as a Gabrielite family, we work towards creating opportunities for every Gabrielite to be a leader, sportsman, and achiever, right? So when we talk about being a leader, and I think many of the parents are leaders in your own field, in your own work, and it's not about the position, it's about serving, it's about sacrifice, right? And in St. Gabriel's Primary School, you will realize that your sons will have many different opportunities to lead, from the traditional class monitor, subject monitor, to becoming peer support leaders, national education ambassadors, and so on and so forth, where they learn to come out of their comfort zone to help to serve others. And in the process, they realize that leadership is not an easy job because not everyone listens to you all the time. And it tests their perseverance, all right, their resolve, right? And it creates a great learning opportunity for them as a leader, right? And becoming a sportsman, right? Later, our colleagues will share with you some of the sports programs we have. I must qualify that we are not trying to develop Olympians here through our sports programs. Of course, in the process, if St. Gabriel's Primary School helps Singapore produce more Olympians, I will be most glad. But it is really about helping our Gabrielites to develop and have this healthy lifestyle habit, right? To enjoy sports, right? To be resilient. Because when they take part in sports, whether it's inter-school game or inter-class game in the school, they learn to pick themselves up from challenges, from losses, all right, from defeats, all right, and to pick themselves up and to move on, to continue to persevere, to learn, to grow. And after all our Gabrielites, and from our profile, I'll share with you, Singaporean boys take up most of the places in St. Gabriel's Primary School, followed by a small number of PRs, and there are hardly any places left for international students because most Singaporean boys would have taken up the places. And so as a result, our boys will be ready for national service when the time comes because they are fit and healthy. Last but not least, the third outcome, the achiever outcome, is about inspiring our Gabrielites to achieve in all areas, be an all-round achiever, not just in your studies, in your character, in your CCA, right, in your service to the community, right? And we have a goal setting process in the school where we help our Gabrielites to set goals, put in place plans, review, reflect as they work towards their goals, right? So a little bit about the history of the school in case some of you are new to the school, right? Last year, we just celebrated our 70th anniversary, right? And our founder is St. Louis Marie de Montfort, right? A man known as someone who, or is known as a man for others, in short, right? And he came from a very good family in France, but he gave up everything to become a priest, right? And in the process, helped to build churches, helped to set up schools, help people in need, the beggars, and so on, right? And later on, the missionaries came to Southeast Asia, came to Singapore to set up St. Gabriel schools, right? And so the school has a legacy where we strive to serve the last, the lost, and the least. The last, the lost, and the least. And this philosophy has great implications for us right till today. Even till today, right, we continue to embrace that philosophy where we leave no child behind. We do our best to cater to every boy that joins us, right? The high ability, the average boy, those who are slow learners, some who may have mild special needs, right? We try to help every boy grow and learn when they are with us, right? Now, a little bit about the teachers. Of course, in every school, the teachers make the greatest difference. The teachers make the greatest difference. And I will share with you very honestly, hand on heart, as an educator who has been to 6-7 schools in my career so far, my 30 years career as an educator. The teachers here in St. Gabriel's, I would say, are godsend, are a blessing to the children every day. Because they know this is God's school, these are God's children. Our teachers leave no stone unturned to provide care for the children, help them in their learning, work closely with the parents, all right, engaging the parents, because we know in primary education, all right, the school is only half the equation. The other half of the equation actually would be the homes, the parents, and together we form a winning equation to help our boys have a good education that prepares them for the future, right? So the staff here, from the admin staff to our teaching staff, right? Everyone believes in treating every child as our own, right? And we provide them with the best possible care that we can provide. And for primary school, I would like to emphasize that safety is the most important thing, right? I think as primary school, as parents, you know, ensuring that your child is safe every day is very important. Coming to school, having a safe, a happy day in school, and being able to pick them up after school, all right, is something very important. And we place great importance in that. We have a lot of processes in place. And I would say most importantly, we have a lot of staff on the ground. Staff on the ground before school, during lessons, at recess time, after school, where the traffic volume is very high, students moving around, having recess play, and we are all there to ensure that the students are safe, right? Okay, so this is something that we take very, very seriously. Okay, if you don't have safety, all right, everything else is secondary. Good CCA results, good academic results. I mean, sometimes, right, you know, all this is really secondary to the child's safety. The other thing that we emphasize a lot in St. Gabriel's Primary School is homeschool partnership. Homeschool partnership. So if you join us as a parent, you will find that we communicate a lot with you, right? Through various means, right? And we have a very established app that we use school-wide that's called the Class Dojo, right? Where teachers communicate with the parents regularly. We have a monthly Parent Connect newsletter, where I'll have message for the parents and also other important information. We have a parent-teacher meet, right, twice a year, right? And on top of that, teachers are always available through email or through appointments to meet up, right, so that we can work closely together, right? And I stress again, in a primary school setting, this parent-teacher relationship is perhaps the most important relationship to enabling the child to feel safe, to feel supported in school, right? Of course, we have a very strong PSG with parent volunteers that are growing from strength to strength, especially after the pandemic where school reopened. And we are very grateful to this very strong PSG that we have. Now, our curriculum is a very unique one. I would share with parents here that recently we underwent MOE validation. MOE validation is a process where MOE sends in their team of officers to validate the school's processes. And an important part of the report was that they stated and they could see very clearly that St. Gabriel's Primary School has a curriculum that caters to students of different needs, all right, through different programs, whether it's the high ability program. And I must stress quite a bit on this high ability program, because the fact is we have a lot of very bright and brilliant boys in St. Gabriel's Primary School, whereby the average curriculum will not really be able to engage them, right? Not be able to stretch them. So we have a Louis Marie de Montfort program. Later, we also have a video to share with you about what this program is all about, all right, for the high ability students. And we also have programs that help students who may be a bit slower in their learning. They need more guidance from the teachers. So we have small class pull-out lessons. We have the learning support program, learning support for maths, mother tongue support program. You name it, we have it to help students who need more help. and then students with special needs. We have a small team. But I must say that for special students with special needs, I must qualify from the start that we are not a SPED school. We're not a special education school. So our resources are not as good as the SPED school. So, but within whatever limited resources we have and personnel we have, right, we work closely with MOE to support some of these children with mild special needs. But if the child has a very high special needs, moderate to high special needs, it will be quite challenging for us to provide a suitable education for some of these boys, right? But on a case-by-case basis, we can look further into each child's needs. And within our curriculum, we use technology widely, right? And today, our boys are all digital natives. So we have a lot of IT programs like our Gabrielite digital literacy program that teaches the boys about design thinking and using coding to find solutions to some of the problems we have around us, like creating a smart home, a smart school, a smart nation, right? And on an ongoing basis and on a daily basis, our teachers use a lot of IT tools in learning, okay? Different apps like Bluecurt, right? And we also have the SLS system, right? And a tablet in each hand is one of the best ways to ensure the students are very focused, very motivated in their learning, right? So we have a lot of IT in learning. At the same time, we are very well aware of one of the rising issues that our youth face today, which is too much screen time, too much time on social media, and sometimes becoming victims of some of these social cyber issues that we have. So we have a cyber wellness program that continuously educate the children to be responsible with the use of IT, at the same time to be discerning when they are online on social media, because they could meet meeting with strangers from all over the world, right? Yeah. And so our co-curriculum, right, in this validation report from MOE, it also singled out St. Gabriel's Primary School as having a very strong co-curriculum, whereby there are leadership lessons and programs in place to develop our students to be leaders. We have a very good values in education program where our students go out of their comfort zone. Like, for example, recently, our primary three students visited the St. Luke's Elder Care to spend an afternoon with the elderly. They planned, designed games and programs, and they visited these homes to play the games with this elderly and to bring joy, all right, and laughter to some of these elderly, right? And there are other VIA programs. Like, for example, you might have seen the video earlier about our P6 boys who were part of the Green Carnival with Barrel Heights CC, right, where they engage the community, to educate the community about climate change issues, all right, through their various project works. CCA is a highlight in St. Gabriel's Primary School. The boys love CCA. Our boys love sports here, right? And you know, we have various CCAs and we do very well in CCA at the national platform, in the national school game. In fact, in the recently concluded national soccer competition, we were second runner-up in Singapore amongst all the primary schools. For floorball, we were fourth in the whole of Singapore, all right? And we also have strong badminton, basketball team and a very strong track and field team because boys are all natural runners, right? Many of them are natural runners, throwers, jumpers, okay? And so we know the profile of our boys. We know where their strengths are. And so the school actively creates a lot of these opportunities, right, for our boys to take part in sports. But I must stress again, it is not to develop national athletes or Olympian, but help them develop a healthy lifestyle, embrace healthy living, right? So that they will be fit and healthy and have a strong mind. The other feature, which is very unique in St. Gabriel's Primary School, something we adopted from the pandemic days, is our recess play program. Our recess play program is a very special program. And I must tell you, for Gabrielites, right? And this is off the script. I'll share you. We had a director who visited St. Gabriel Primary School sometime back. So the director interviewed some of the boys and asked them, what is the most important lesson to you in St. Gabriel's Primary School? And tongue-in-cheek, but probably quite serious, the boy actually told him recess is the most important lesson in the whole day. Right? And we can understand why. Because for the boys, I think the studies are important, but time to play is important. Time for them to run around, kick a ball, play badminton, you know, all right, interact with the friends, you know, is important. So not surprisingly, recess is a very important time of the day for our boys. And so with that, we have a recess play program. We have different play areas for different classes every day. And this is rotated from Monday to Friday, where the boys will go to the different play areas with their classmates and in the process build their friendships. Now, a lot of parents also wonder, as a Catholic school, what kind of programs do we have to develop this Catholic ethos, right? So indeed, we have a variety of Catholic programs, okay, from our RE Religious Education Program, which is an opt-in basis for Catholic boys and even non-Catholic boys who want to join us to learn more about the life of Jesus, the life of Mary, St. Louis Marie de Montfort and all his virtues, right? We celebrate masses as a school, right? For example, beginning of the school year mass, our founders mass, Thanksgiving mass. We have a Catholic club CCA. We have masses on days of obligation just for the Catholic boys in our chapel. Yes, we have a chapel, right? And on an ongoing basis, we have very, very interesting programs like the Easter Carnival, you know, all right, where we celebrate Easter, all right? And so the Catholic ethos is strong, all right, in St. Gabriel's Primary School. We start the school day with a prayer. We have after recess prayer, all right? And we have end of the school day prayer, all right, where we thank the Lord for protecting our staff and our boys. And I will share with you personally, having been to secular schools and then coming to lead St. Gabriel's Primary School, in St. Gabriel's Primary School, there is something special. The Lord is looking after the staff and students. I can feel it. And many a times, when the going gets tough, our prayers have been answered. For example, when some student is unwell, a teacher is facing some serious family problems, all right, there's a mini crisis in the school, particularly during the pandemic. During the pandemic, really, we could feel the invisible hand protecting and looking after our staff and our boys in the school. All right. Okay. Oh, if your son is joining primary one and this is your first child joining the primary school education system, I must share with you, you are joining the primary school education system at a very exciting time, in a time of change where the shift is well underway to move away from an overemphasis on the academics to creating more time and space and opportunity for our boys to develop all round in their character, in their 21st century competencies, in their other pursuits, all right, in their physical ability, their social, emotional, looking after the mental well-being of the boys, all right, helping them become an all-rounded individual, not someone who is just head smart, all right, but someone who is able to connect, interact with other people, right, who has his virtues in the right place, right? So with that, the school programs are now very different from the time you were in school or maybe about 10, 20 years ago, right? And so in St. Gabriel's Primary School, I would say we were ahead of the curve. And I say this about what was happening even before I joined the school. The school was already very forward-looking in the true tradition of St. Gabriel's education, which was to really focus on the character education of our boys. And up to today, whenever I meet a lot of the old boys, the alumni, they never cease to impress me, amaze me with how street smart they are, how entrepreneurial they are, right? They may not always be your A students, all right, but they truly have their heart in the right place. They want to come back to serve the school. They want to help the community, all right, and they are doing a lot of good work in our community, in their own areas of specialization, in the different industries they are in. All right, just a check on time to see whether the time is still good. Okay, right. I would just touch on one other important aspect I'd like to share up front, which is the past few years P1 registration statistics. Right. So in the past few years, we have gone into balloting. We have gone into balloting. And in all likelihood, MOE has yet to confirm, but we will have 150 places. We have 150 places, all boys, right? And we have gone into balloting. And my prediction, I think this year we will go into balloting again in phase 2C, right? Okay. So I just want to share this with parents. Okay. And I think MOE has already had a press release recently to say that P1 registration this year will start in July. We'll go all the way to August, all right? Go all the way to August, right? So I think in the course of these next few weeks, in the run-up to P1 registration, if you would like more information, do let us know, okay? So I think at this point, I will just hand it back to my colleagues who will take you through some other programs, and then I'll see you again later, right? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Tan. Let's learn about our students' experiences in SGPS through the voices of two of our Primary 1 Gabrielites.
Hello everyone, my name is Ian Josh. Now for Primary 1 Perseverance. Today, Alex and I would like to share more about our experiences in St. Gabriel's Primary School. I love going to St. Gabriel's Primary School because I get to learn new things every day and play with my friends during recess.
Hello, my name is Elliot and I'm from Primary 1 Society. I have many friendly classmates and we work together on group projects and assignments. Sometimes we have show and tell. When we bring something to school, we share with the class. I'm excited to see what my classmates bring and I'll always learn a new thing from them.
Stories and activities to help me understand the lessons better. We also have special classes like art, music, physical education, and health, which I really enjoy because I get to express myself and be creative. I've been having a wonderful time in St. Gabriel's Primary School. Every day, I feel happy and excited to go to school and see all my friends and teachers. I'm grateful for all the opportunities my school have given me to learn and grow.
In school, we have rules that we have to follow, like raising up our hand to ask a question and being respectful to our classmates and teachers. We also have rewards for good behavior, like stickers and praises from our teacher. It feels great to be recognized for doing the right thing. Overall, my learning experience in primary school has been great. I feel happy and excited to go to school every day, and I know I'm gaining knowledge and skills that will help me in the future.
Next, let's watch a video to learn more about a signature program in our school, the Louis-Marie de Montfort program, also known as the LMM program, which aims to cultivate the spirit of lifelong learning in our Primary 4, 5, and 6 students. The program also caters to these students' needs so that they can benefit from a more robust and academically challenging curriculum. Apart from enriching our students through programs designed for the 4 academic subjects, students in the LMM program are also challenged in other competencies such as coding and innovation. Let's watch the video.
Hello everybody, I'm Declan from 4Odd. A critical and innovative thinker is what I am. I use pieces of information to make connections and draw conclusions.
Hi everyone, I'm Yahya Fauzan from Primary 4 Loyalty. A resilient and self-directed learner is what I am. I own my learning and take risks without fear of failure. Bring it on!
Hi, I'm Ryan Yap from 4 Loyalty. A convincing and confident communicator is what I am. This is firstly that I'm a great listener, and I can complement what others are saying with my own thoughts and ideas.
Hi everyone, I'm Edward from 4 Orderliness. An empathetic and morally responsible person is who I am. Just like our founding father, Louis-Marie de Montfort, I recognize, feel, and respond to the needs of people around me. Whenever there's someone suffering in silence, I want to be there for them.
The LMM program is a signature program in St. Gabriel's Primary School that aims to stretch our high ability learners. Now, these learners typically learn at a very fast pace, and our normal curriculum will not be able to engage them well. So St. Gabriel's Primary School has this program that prepares our students for the future to become self-directed and confident learners, and students with resilience to face the future.
Albert Einstein once said that the important thing is not to stop questioning. Curiosity has its own reason for existing. In our quest for knowledge, we are often guided by our ability to question, analyze, and evaluate the things around us.
The Innovation Program, IVP, an initiative from MOE Gifted Education Branch, provides us a unique opportunity for us to develop our skills and strategies for generating ideas and evaluating solutions to address the issues faced. Conducting surveys to gather information on products, making prototypes, and writing reports on our innovations. The Coding Enrichment Program is another avenue that enables us to work in teams in the field of computational thinking. We are introduced to computational coding concepts through a blend of software inputs and hardware outputs.
Learning never ends with us because life is full of challenges. We seek knowledge in our efforts to find solutions and thus overcome them with confidence. By doing so, we grow to become resilient and wiser Gabrielites. Through the E2K Maths and Science program, we learn reasoning skills and deepen our conceptual understanding through an inquiry approach.
The E2K Mathematics program is designed to enable us to develop mathematical reasoning skills so that we can deepen our understanding of the subject through an inquiry approach. We even get to collaborate with our peers and engage in mathematical thinking through puzzles, games, and explorative activities. Thanks to the E2K Science program, we get to develop scientific inquiry process skills as well as attain other important 21st century competencies such as resilience and resourcefulness, critical and inventive thinking, and effective communication skills. Apart from the various programs, our daily lessons are prepped with lots of engaging activities and experiments where we get to investigate and extend on our learning beyond the four walls of the classroom. For instance, during a recent science lesson, we applied what we learned on the topic of heat to create a solar sail. We certainly had lots of fun doing so.
It is said that communication is the key to success in any situation. However, for communication to be effective, we first need to make sure that we can convince our audience of our speech by being confident in it. As such, we are fortunate to have programs designed for us to bring out the best in us when we deliver thoughts and ideas.
The literature program enables us to not only express ideas through speech, but to also express them through film. Yes, film literally is an integral part of our Primary 5 literature program. Our Gabrielites have had the opportunity to create short films. We incorporate specific shot sizes and angles when framing each scene. This emphasizes the relationship between the characters and their surroundings to the audience. The LMM Higher Chinese program is another great opportunity for us to understand how a language can be experienced and enjoyed through various platforms. This year, we created our own short films using the Book Creator app. We unleashed our creativity and learned the importance of respect and teamwork during the process. In fact, we had a lot of fun watching the videos created by our friends. Apart from the videos, some of us also got a glimpse of how the broadcasting media industry works by scripting and recording a podcast. We had so much fun and felt as if we were actual DJs at a radio station. Our favorite program has got to be the speech and drama class. Not only did we get to perform an act, we also got to play many interesting games. The LMM Higher Chinese program is indeed so much fun. Now, we are much more confident when it comes to speaking Mandarin.
As part of the efforts to promote empathy and care for others around us, we get to participate in the various value and action programs organized by the school. For instance, in order to create awareness about food wastage and play our part to help reduce food wastage, students from Four Orderliness held a food collection drive. The beneficiaries of this donation drive include family service centers, homes, soup kitchens, and voluntary welfare organizations. This drive took place during the Virtues Week, which is in line with our founder Louis Marie de Montfort's belief in helping others in need. Apart from this, we also have the Save the Pens campaign, where our LMM Gabrielites get to convince their schoolmates to donate unwanted pens and pencils. The project aims to create awareness in students to reduce wastage and to recycle whenever possible. Pens collected from students would be refilled or donated to underprivileged students in Singapore and the region. Pens which could not be refilled or reused are stripped of their plastic and metal parts for recycling.
We thank you for joining us, learning more about our LMM program. However, this is not the end of our journey with you.
Yes, we hope to see you soon.
As our motto goes, labor conquers all, we hope the labor of love in showcasing the LMM program to you will dominate your hearts and minds.
Bye!
Now, Mr. Jimmy Tong will share on GFA and CCA for the holistic development of our Gabrielites. Mr. Tong, please.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Sorry for the slight delay there. I was trying to get the camera back on. I'm Mr. Jimmy Tong, head of the Department for Physical Health Education and CCA. Every child is talented in his own way. At St. Gabriel's, we expose your child to a wide variety of activities, even at the lower primary levels. Our CCA provide a good platform for your child to engage in something that he excels in, or has a strong interest in a wide variety of CCA offered at our school, from sports and games, such as the Gabrielite Sports Academy, the Gabrielite Football Academy, to clubs and societies, such as Robotics Club, our brass band, and uniform groups as well, like our scouts. Now, to give you a good idea of what we offer at CCA level, I think let's sit back and watch a video. It will showcase all that we have to offer.
Mm-hmm.
I hope you enjoyed the video there. It showcased what our school had to offer. Now, at St. Gabriel Primary School, our boys are somehow strongly drawn to sports. This is very evident during PE lessons and our daily structured recess program. As a result, it is not surprising that a large percentage of our boys do choose sports as their CCA. Just to give you a rough idea, about 65% of each cohort actually choose sports as their CCA when they begin their CCA journey at P3. Our Gabrielite Football Academy and Gabrielite Badminton Academy alone have a membership of about 250 students. Right, the other sports we offer include athletics, basketball, golf, wushu, and floorball. You might be wondering what is the difference between a normal sports CCA or an academy. Well, the short answer to this is that everyone is welcome in the Gabrielite Football Academy and Badminton Academy. There's also some sports leadership component that we teach the students. And regardless of competitive teams or recreation team, all students will get a chance to train. Do find out more about this from our website. Apart from sports, we also have CCAs in other domains like the aesthetics clubs and uniform group. Our robotics club and band has constantly delivered wonderful achievements and is very popular as well. Our scouts are also attracting a fair bit of interest because of the outdoor and field activities they participate in. There's also strong collaboration with St. Gabriel Secondary for our young scout cups. Finally, you might have noticed in a video about this program called the Gabrielite Sports Excellence Program, which I think many P1 and P2 students will be keen to find out more. This is basically a multi-sports program for selected boys at P1 and P2, right? It is not a CCA, but at P1 and P2, selected boys will undergo a twice-a-week training where we start to expose them in multiple sports. Eventually, these boys can opt to do multiple sports at national school games level, right? This program has brought us a lot of achievements, as shown in the video, and we trust that the boys who are talented in sports will find this very attractive. Okay. At primary school, children are officially encouraged to join CCA from P3. While it is not compulsory to have a CCA in primary school, it is strongly encouraged as it is part of a child's holistic development. At P1 and P2, students are already exposed to a wide range of physical, aesthetic, music, and technology activities during PE lessons, PEL lessons, music lessons, as well as art lessons. At P3, students can then choose a CCA that he is talented and interested in. However, at SGPS, we do not shortlist P1 and 2 and boys to be part of CCA program yet. Right? So, one of the popular questions that parents like to ask is, when do your children start CCA? So I hope that through this explanation, right, the exposure given at P1 and 2 through the various PEL, PE, and music lessons, your answers to this will be there. Finally, we are a Catholic school. There is a Catholic club whereby students can join. It's every Wednesday. And we do encourage students who are Catholics to be part of this. Thank you very much. I will pass the time back to my colleagues.
Thank you, Mr. Tong. Here are some commonly asked questions before we move on to the Q&A segment. Registration at each phase is based on your eligibility at that phase. For more information on Primary 1 registration, please visit the MOE website. Our school hours. We start at 7:30 a.m. daily. However, students are advised to be in class latest by 7:25 a.m. to prepare themselves for the start of the day. Dismissal is at 1:30 p.m. Mondays to Thursdays and 1 p.m. on Fridays. What strategies do we use for students who are weak in mother tongue? For primary 2 students, there is a reading support program conducted during curriculum. There is also an in-house primary 2 learning support program to support students in the learning of Chinese language. For primary 3 and 4 students, the mother tongue support program supports students in the learning of mother tongue language during curriculum time. How do we support students with needs? Learning support is provided for primary 1 students who require additional help with English language or mathematics. Those who are identified will receive support through the Learning Support Program for English, LSP, and Learning Support for Mathematics, LSM. Depending on the needs of the students, the school's special education needs, SEN offices may conduct withdrawal sessions to provide learning and behavior support for up to 1 hour per week. The school's policy and measures on dealing with bullying. Students are constantly educated and reminded through a set of infographics on Say No to Bullying, prominently displayed in each classroom, as well as through talks by school leaders and teachers during assembly. The school works in partnership with parents to curb further these issues. School stresses on the importance of using the whole school approach to discipline using the Modified Restorative Practices, MRP. Measures taken include home involvement, counseling, class apology, issuance of letters of notification or offense, suspension of recess play, suspension from CCA, or suspension from school. How does the school promote the Catholic ethos? In SGPS, we create a very Catholic environment for the students and staff. Daily prayers are said and masses are held in the school throughout the year. Religious education lessons, known as RE lessons, are held for all Catholic students. Non-Catholic students with parental consent also participate in these lessons. Finally, there are important signs and symbols of the Catholic faith placed around the school. Other administrative matters. NESCAN is a student care center based in St. Gabriel's Primary School. As the student care is located within the school premises, no arrangement is required to send the boys to the student care. However, parents do need to make their own arrangements to take the child home in the evening. For more information about student care, school bus, bookshop, and school uniform, please visit our school website. I'll now invite our vice principals, Mr. John Lim and Madam Chua, to say a few words. Over to you, Mr. Lim.
Hi, parents. A very good morning to all parents. So glad that you can join us for this morning's e-open house. St. Gabriel's Primary pride itself in a brand of education that is holistic to help our boys discover and develop their strengths and interests while moving away from an overemphasis on academic results. Our dedicated teachers and staff endeavor to prepare our boys for the future as leaders, sportsmen, and achievers, with a good balance of academic and non-academic areas, from our P6 Resilience Project to our Gabrielite Digital Literacy Program to E2K Mathematics and Science Programs. Our boys are exposed to a wide range of future-ready skills and competencies. Our students do well in various competitions, and they are given opportunities to participate in a wide range of external programs. These include the National School Games, various Maths and Science Olympiad competitions, the annual P5 Outdoor Adventure Camp, just to name a few. Finally, allow me to give a special mention to our amazing parent support group, who play an active role in supporting the school's efforts in spiritual formation, character development, and so on. Their efforts goes into co-organizing our annual Easter Carnival, praying for our boys during the PSLE week, to celebrating Teachers' Day and graduation day for our P6 cohort. Thank you, and we look forward to a very active Q&A time later.
Thank you, Mr. Lim. Over to you, Madam Chua.
Hello, good morning, parents. Let me reiterate three things about St. Gabriel's Primary School. Number one, St. Gabriel's Primary School is a school with a heart. Our dedicated and caring teachers are committed to nurturing each child's potential by fostering a supportive environment where every child feels safe, valued, cared for, and understood. Number two, St. Gabriel's Primary School believes in the joy of learning and that learning is for life. our educators go beyond the traditional teaching methods, harnessing technology, using hands-on constructivist approach, experimentation, questioning technique to make lessons come alive so that learning is fun, engaging, and memorable. Our students also learn digital literacy skills from P1 all the way to P6. At P1 level, they do internet skills, keyboarding, and coding to enable them to learn beyond the school, beyond the text, and to learn for life. Number three, St. Gabriel's Primary School believes in character development. Besides equipping our students with the skills and the knowledge needed to excel in a rapidly changing world, we ground them in core values of respect, integrity, and responsibility so that they grow up to be morally upright citizens. From leadership to character development, we provide every opportunity for our boys to grow in confidence and capability. Our curriculum is rich and diverse, laying a strong foundation in literacy and numeracy, which are building blocks of a primary education. We nurture strengths, develop interests, and embrace talents. And we look forward to partnering you in ensuring a bright, successful, and happy future for your child. So don't wait. Welcome to St. Gabriel's Primary School. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chua. We shall now move on to the Q&A segment. The Q&A panel is headed by our principal and vice principals and supported by various members of our school's executive committee. Please type your questions into the Q&A box. Our panel will try to answer them during this live Q&A segment. Our principal, Mr. Martin Tan, will lead this segment. Mr. Tan, over to you.
Thank you, Serene. Hi, parents. Good to see you again. Actually, in the past hour, I can see about 50 questions have already been typed and responded to, right? So I think there are only a few questions left, right? And I think the panel has left me to answer these last few questions. All right, I think the first one first. Okay, I think on a very serious note, how long more will I be in St. Gabriel's Primary School? I will just be very honest, very upfront. I think parents are asking this question because everyone is aware of the principal rotation system that MOE has. At the same time, I would say that as of this moment, I have not heard from MOE. All right, there's no news about my rotation. And we also know that the principal's rotation, a principal's stint in the school could range from anything from 6 years to 8 years. And we've seen some cases, very special cases, the principal in the school for 10 years. Right? So as far as I'm concerned, I've already started making plans for next year in St. Gabriel's Primary School. My team will tell you, we already got plans in place for next year in our review and what are our plans going forward. Right, so I'm looking forward to it. Right, so it all depends on MOE. At the same time, I would like to say that a good school is not just about the principal. Definitely not. A good school is about a good team of teachers. And I will share with you that over the last few years, we have built up a very strong team of teachers led by a very strong team of key personnel. Right, our key personnel has come of age. They have been learning all these years and they're all very strong HODs, very strong subject heads and senior teachers in their respective areas. And all these programs we share with you is not dependent on the principal. All these good programs we have, whoever is the principal, these programs are here to stay because these programs are good for our students. These programs have been validated by MOE to be very good developmental programs for our students. And these are all helmed by our very strong head of departments, right? And definitely they will see to it that these programs continue for the benefit of our students. So I would say that while the principal has a role to play, it is equally important that the school has a strong team of staff that will see St. Gabriel's going on to the next level, come what may. Right? And this is the assurance I can share with all the parents that we have a very strong team of staff in St. Gabriel's Primary School build up over the years, right? And everyone is very focused on the mission to help Gabrielites become leaders, sportsmen, and achiever, and to ensure that no one is left behind, not the last, not the lost, not the least. Okay, so that's for that question. And the other second important question is, I think after hearing Maristella, after hearing about ACS going co-ed, it is also on the minds of parents. Will St. Gabriel's go co-ed? I will share with you again, very upfront, it's not going to happen in the short term, right? There are no plans to go co-ed in the next few years. But is this going to be permanent? That I can't say, right? Because we cannot tell what the future holds, right? But at the moment, I think the St. Gabriel's Foundation and family of schools, which, like some of you highlighted earlier, includes Montfort, all right? We are part of the same family of schools, Montfort, St. Gabriel, Assumption. We are currently of the view that there is a lot of value in an all-boys education, right? And my personal view is, having been in a co-ed primary school, I shared with you earlier, and then coming to all-boys school, I can see very strong focus on the part of the boys for their learning, right? And also very strong focus for the school in terms of the staff teaching pedagogy and the way we use our resources, right? And we are able to really support the boys in their learning, right, in the 6 years with us. So we see a lot of advantages in terms of being the all-boys school that we are now, right? And again, I must qualify, of course, no one can predict the future, right? You know, right? So at the moment, we will be all-boys school for a few more years to come, right? So beyond that, I think going co-ed, like what Maristella and ACS have done, it is about engaging all the stakeholders, the old boys, the current parents, the staff, and the whole school community about such a decision. Okay. So I hope that answers those two questions about principalship and about going co-ed. Now, let me just add to some of the questions my colleagues have shared. Now, while we share a lot about opportunities in sports, I would like to say that we are very well aware that there are some boys who are artistically inclined or musically inclined or very, very IT savvy, right? So these boys are not really your sportsmen per se, right? They take part in sports, but they are really good in art, really good in music. And I also want to assure parents that we cater to these boys, right? We have boys who do very well. Okay, they are very good in art, very talented in drawing. They run up to me and show me the cartoons that they draw. Very creative minds. And we appreciate and we allow those talents to bloom as well, right? And I think the important question also was, while we are a Catholic school, the point remains that we are inclusive. We are well aware that we have a lot of non-Catholic boys in our midst. I mean, even in our teaching staff, we also have a lot of non-Catholic teachers. So the history of the school, the tradition of the school is such that we are inclusive. We are very mindful. And a lot of the virtues that St. Louis Marie de Montfort, our founder, espoused are universal values, actually. Actually, universal values. Not Catholic values per se. For example, respect. Respecting others. It is something universal. So when we teach the boys about respect, it's about respecting everyone regardless of race, language, or religion, which is our national pledge, right? So I again assure parents not to be too worried if you're not Catholic, right, or you're not Christian. We are an inclusive school. We have a high number of Muslim students, Hindu students in our midst, right? And we welcome everyone from all walks of life, different backgrounds, different race, language, or religion. Okay, let's have a look at the Q&A box. Okay, some of them are being answered. Are we looking into AI? All right, that's an interesting question. That's a forward-looking question. And that's a question we are looking at too. Okay. Right, so the co-ed one has been answered. cost for buying laptop and tablet at the moment the school provides? Okay, all these, all right, I think it's being answered too. Of course, if you like to invest in one at home, you know, by all means, right? By all means, right? Because I think the pandemic has shown us that there comes a time when there's a need for home-based learning. I think everyone is aware of it. Even affected primary kindergarten children, you know? Okay, so if you want to invest in one, by all means, do so. But we are also well aware sometimes we have families that are not doing so well, and we help our boys. I'll help our boys. We loan out laptops and tablets to them so that they can use at home for their home-based learning, right? Okay. Let's see what other questions there are. Okay, this is a very good question here. What are the major changes, enhancement you plan for the school for 2025? What an excellent question. I should invite this parent onto my strategic planning team. Very good question. I would like to share that St. Gabriel's Primary School is not a school that operates on its own. We are part of a larger system, which is the Singapore education system. So whatever we do here, whatever we provide for our boys is very much aligned to the larger national landscape. And at the moment, the Singapore education system is very focused, very concerned about going beyond the academics to help our boys develop what we call the 21CC. So 21CC are some of the soft skills like ability to collaborate, ability to communicate, have adaptive, inventive thinking. All right, and has cross-cultural literacy. That means understanding the world around you. So St. Gabriel's Primary School has been on this journey for some time. And going forward in the next few years, we want to see how we are more structured and we are sharper in this program to develop these competencies in our books. Now, to develop the students' academic abilities in English, maths, and science and mother tongue is tried and tested. Schools have been doing it for years. How the teachers teach, how we assess, is all proven, all tried and tested. However, going into the realm of 21CC development is a brand new ball game for educators. So what is actually happening is that while the school has this vision, right, the teachers are actually learning on the job. There's a lot of training, capacity building, teachers are attending courses, there are a lot of in-house training for the teachers in this area of development of 21CC in our boys. So in the coming years, this is going to take a lot of our attention, all right, energy and resources as we strive to preparing our boys for the future. We want our Gabrielites to stand out, you know, in the crowd as they progress, right, in society and become a valuable contributor to our nation. Do you accept transfer from other schools? My eldest is currently in P4. Okay, you're welcome to put him on our wait list. You're welcome to put him on our wait list. There's a wait list form on our website, right? And there are sometimes some movement in the current enrollment, current students, because now after the pandemic, we have parents who are posted overseas. All right, and bring the family along, and then so the boy has to go with the father or mother, and that creates vacancies, you know, and then that's when we can consider possible students from to be transferred in from other school. Yes, please submit your application form. Okay, the other thing about information about the school, I must share with you. With the advent of social media, we actually update our Facebook a lot more than we update our website, right? So if you want the latest about our school, like yesterday, what happened in school yesterday? Like I told you, the book character day, right? And it's updated very, very in real time, very, very fast, right? So I like to encourage parents here today. You really want to know more about the school, feel the vibes, go into our Facebook. Our Facebook is very lively, right? And is updated very, very regularly. Okay. Okay, do you have any more questions? Well, I must say that it's been a very lively and dynamic e-open house. So you, as you can see, e-open house can be as good as a physical open house, or if not even better, right? Okay, because you are actually joining us on the comfort of your homes or wherever you are at your convenience, you know, and you don't have to physically come down here on a Saturday morning, the first day of the school holidays, right? I'm sure there are better things to do. Having said that, I would like to reiterate again, if you feel there's a need for a physical tour, maybe to help your son be more comfortable, all right, looking at the facilities and reading some of the wall, the learning that we have on the walls, and look at how the school is curated and all that, please drop us an email. We'll be happy to arrange for a group tour, guided tour, all right, in the coming weeks, right? And we'll be happy to do that. Okay, all right. Okay, let me just have one last look at the Q&A column to see that we've got everything answered. We got deferment approval from MOE days back. Should we register our child? Okay, this is a very individualized question, all right? Maybe we will take that offline, okay? Maybe you get in touch with us, get in touch with Ms. Chua Bi Peng, my admin manager, about deferment from P1, okay? All right, and then we will take this offline, okay? St. Gabriel Secondary School has a mixed reputation. Do you see any knock-on effect on SGPS? St. Gabriel Secondary School is a good school. I'll share with you from my experience of working with them. They have very good programs, very good school leadership team there with the staff, because we have a lot of combined programs. There's a lot of collaboration between the two schools, right? And I know the school also has a very strong caring culture, right? And a lot of our boys who join St. Gabriel's Secondary after the primary feel very at home from the first day of school. And the best example I can give you is our SMC chairman, Dr. Francis Chong. Dr. Francis Chong, years ago, was the top PSLE student in Singapore from St. Gabriel's Primary School. And Dr. Francis Chong had in front of him any school he liked to choose. And he chose to go to St. Gabriel's Secondary School. His father said he will leave it to his son to decide. And like they say, the rest is history. Dr. Francis Chong from St. Gabriel's Primary, top PSLE student, went to St. Gabriel's Secondary School, eventually became a president scholar. Today is a senior director in the Ministry of Trade and Industry, continuing to carry the Singapore flag high in far, far places to help establish trade ties for Singapore, and comes back to serve as our school management committee chairman as his way of giving back to the school and society. I think I rest my case if you look at the benefits of going on to St. Gabriel Secondary. Okay. Of course, that is quite a distant question, right? I think your immediate concern must be the immediate, which is the best primary school for your child, right? Once you get into the primary school of your choice, we will lead you from there at the next stage of your son's education, what to look out for in lower, middle, upper primary, and then coming to the choice of secondary school. So thank you very much, everyone, for all the great questions you've posed for us today. We hope that you found the session useful, and we've certainly tried our best to provide all the information you need. And really, we look forward to seeing you soon. Thank you very much. Back to you, MC.
Thank you, Mr. Tan. If you have further questions, you may email them to us via this email address. Back to you, Mr. Tan, for the closure of today's webinar.
All right, I thought I closed it already. Anyway, it's okay. Yeah, thank you so much, everyone. And this is the start of the school holidays for all the kindergarteners, right? I wish you and your family a very happy and safe holiday, right? And as I said, see you soon. Labor omnia vincit. That's our school motto. Thank you very much. Bye, everyone.
Thank you, Mr. Tan. Please visit our school's website to know more about our school programs and for other information on Primary 1 registration. Thank you again for joining us today and have a good weekend. Bye.